Today, we're going to talk about being a more efficient Salesforce professional. This involves using some Google Chrome extensions that I find very valuable, as well as some other tips and tricks to help you get the same job you're getting done today in a much shorter amount of time while still providing quality work for your clients and employers. Let's get started. Some of my favorite tools are actually Chrome extensions. So I'm going to share a few of those with you today, and these can really help make you at least a little bit faster, if not significantly faster, when working through your Salesforce administrative duties with your employer. So let's hop right in. So the first one I want to talk about is actually the ability to log into multiple orgs. So this is a great Chrome extension right here, and all of the links will be in the description of the video. But this is called force.com logins, and this allows you to store logins and group logins for different orgs. The free version allows up to 10, which is typically plenty for most people, even consultants. So the great thing about this is from anywhere, as long as I have Google Chrome open, I can just click this icon, choose the org I want to log into, and click new tab. And immediately it logs me into that org. So that is a really quick way to jump from org to org and work in the areas you want to work in. The second one that I'll talk about is actually right here. It's called Salesforce Colored Favicons. And what that really means is it's actually, you'll notice these little cloud icons up here in the browser tabs, and you'll notice they're different colors. Now, each org that I'm logged into shows a different color. So for the org that I just logged into, you can see I have two tabs open for that one. So I have this green icon. This is one of my Trailhead accounts. So this has sort of this maroon icon. And then this is another one of my Trailhead accounts, which has a lime green icon. So it's pretty cool. What happens is you can open up all sorts of different orgs. So you could be in production or in a sandbox or working on Trailhead all at the same time. And it helps you not get confused on what org you're working in. If you work in sandboxes a lot, it can be confusing that, you know, oh, I accidentally made that change in production and I meant to make it in a sandbox. And when you have these colored tabs up at the top, that can really help you make distinctions about which org that you're working in at any given time. Now, another really great extension right up here, and this allows you to log in as anyone in your org. Now, as long as you're a system administrator, you know that you can do that, but usually you would have to navigate over to their user record. So for instance, if I wanted to log in as John here, typically I'm gonna have to come into the setup menu. And then once I'm in the setup menu, many people don't know, you can either come in from the user side and go down to users and find John. A little bit of a shortcut there is that you can actually search here in the Lightning setup, and you can find users directly from here. So the typical route would be to come in here and then click login. Now, the great thing about this tool is that I can be anywhere in Salesforce. So let's go back out to one of the apps here. And all I have to do is come up here, and anyone who's active, and you can see you can actually create views for yourself to only show active users. But right now, I've got this set so I could just log in as John from right here. And immediately I'm logged in as another person so I can do troubleshooting or whatever else I need to do. Now, another really cool feature about this is I could navigate as John. So let's say that I come in and I look at some other dashboards or whatever it is, and then I finish up working under his account and I log out. It takes me back to where I was. So you can see it actually dropped me off in Dreamhouse, but it takes me back to the home tab because that's the app he was in. However, it's really nice. So if you were working a lead record and then you logged in as John and you made some changes and then you logged back out as John, it would take you back to the lead record that you were looking at. So it's really nice in that way that you don't get lost and have to work your way back to what you were doing, and you don't have to navigate through to figure out where you left off. Another app that I'll mention that's really good is that I think a lot of people just choose to send an email or make a phone call whenever they're solutioning for something.
And especially when you're thinking you might want to do a screen share with someone so you can show them the solution to a problem or how to do something. The worst thing for me is getting on a phone call, because you could have something you can cover in 5 minutes, but you end up on the call for 15 or 20 minutes because they want to talk about other things, or they want, you know, some other clarifications about something totally off topic. So the great thing about the tool, and I'm not going to click into it right now, but this icon up here is called Loom for Chrome. And I also recommend Screencastify, but these are both screen videoing tools. And I'm using Loom right now, and that's what I use, the free version, to do all of my recordings. And it's great because all you have to do is click the icon and start recording. You can show someone something and then send them a link to the video and say, hey, here's how you close out those opportunities and get around those error messages that you're seeing, and just send them a quick 60-second video on how to do that. And you don't have to sit on a call with them or email back and forth 4 or 5 times to get a problem solved. So consider using a video screen recording as part of how you're communicating with people to give them solutions to problems. All right, so those are the major items. One other item I'll mention, if you happen to use Gmail, this is pretty neat as far as being able to send emails with voice. Now, a lot of people do that from their phones, and that's pretty normal, but actually sending emails with your voice is another Chrome extension called Dictation for Gmail, and that's really nice. So let's say we're running late to a meeting. All we have to do is queue up an email and then click this icon here. I'm running 5 minutes late, but I'll be there quickly. And that's it. And so now you can very quickly generate emails if you want to send something really quickly and just shoot something off and you don't have time or your hands aren't free for whatever reason. You can shoot those emails off from your desktop. Obviously, you can do a very similar thing from your phone, and it probably works better from your phone. But if you're on your desktop, you don't have your phone with you, or you don't want to go through opening up the right email or the right app, then you can do that directly from your computer. So these are a few tips and tricks specifically around Google Chrome extensions and making your life a lot easier in Salesforce. Now, some other things I'll mention are fairly simple, and that is just make sure you're focusing when you come into the office. A lot of people ask me, how do you get a full-time job done in 3 or 4 hours a day? Well, the way that you do that is when you sit down at your computer at 8 or 8:30, make sure you've already got your coffee and your water ready. Make sure you've already gone to the restroom or whatever you need to do, so that when you sit down at 8 o'clock in the morning, you are ready to work. The other thing is, if you don't use your phone specifically for work or you don't really need to, make sure you put your phone in airplane mode and set it across the room from you so that you're not tempted to pick it up or you don't see the notifications coming in. So just set that phone across the room. That way you can stay focused and maintain focus on the task you're working. So with that, I'm going to move into another subject, which is a lot of people get inundated with, say they have 5 or 6 different things they need to work on. You have to write things down, whether that's a note-taking on your computer or whether that's on an actual notebook or sheet of paper. You need to write your tasks down and get them out of your head. One of my biggest issues is that I store everything up in my head, and if I don't write it down, then I'm constantly going it over and over again in my head, which is a massive waste of time. So if I can write things down, that is hugely beneficial. I know it sounds simple, but if you're not doing that, give it a shot, and you'd be surprised at the mental clarity of simply getting things out of your head and onto paper. Now, the other thing is, don't try to do 2 or 3 tasks at a time. I would even advise, if you're going to work on a real project, like you need to build a process and process builder or a flow, or you need to set up 10 new users or whatever it is, go ahead and mute your emails. You'll notice that you can come up to a site like this and you can say mute this tab. So if you're getting emails from your email, just come up there and mute that site. That'll get it out of your face to where you're just going and looking at it when you want to, and focus in on what you're working on. And you can set a timer for, say, an hour. And that way you can focus in on the project you're working, give time to it for the complete hour, and then come back to your emails and see what's going on and work on some other things. But that is the best thing you can do. The last thing that I'll mention is actually keeping track of your time. So if you notice, this is called Toggl Time Tracker, another Chrome extension. And if you want to keep track of your time here, you can set this up. Again, it's totally free. All of the extensions I've talked about today are totally free. Just go ahead and click this right here. Now you've got a little bit of setup to do to tell it what you're working on and like what projects you have and things like that. But all you've got to do is click this play button right here, and it's going to start logging your time. So you can come back into the tool later, whatever you need to do. You can exit out over here. You'll see it's got a red light up there letting you know that it's keeping track of your time. But say you have multiple projects or multiple clients that you're working for, you can easily keep track of your time up there. So you're working through something and you want to, maybe you're billing it hourly, or you just want to make sure time doesn't get away from you. Then you can come up here, see, okay, I've been working on that for 30 seconds, or hopefully for you, it's 30 minutes to an hour. And then all you have to do is come up here. What are you doing? You know, whatever it is. And then you'll have your projects built within Toggl, and you can add tags if you'd like to. And that's it. And now you've got your time logged into Project One in Toggl. So these are a few tips to help you become more efficient, to help you become more aware of your time, and to get the same job you're getting done today much faster than you were in the past. Now, if you're getting value from our videos, please be sure to like and subscribe. We definitely want to make sure we're bringing you content that is valuable for you and making you a better Salesforce professional. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll have a new video out soon.